To slow the spread of COVID-19 through our communities, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has encouraged Americans to practice social distancing. The goal right now is to slow down the outbreak in order to reduce the chance of infection amongst high-risk populations and to reduce the burden on our healthcare systems and workers. Therefore, our television studios are closed. My guest and I are recording this interview while in our respective homes. Stay safe and stay informed. My name is Dr. Catherine Marshall Woods, and your host for this episode of A Healthy Mind. The purpose of this show is to educate and inform the public regarding emotional disorders and mental health, as well as social policies that affect healthy minds. Meditation has been practiced for thousands of years. According to the Mayo Clinic, presently, meditation is commonly used for relaxation and stress reduction. With us today is Eric Brewington, facilitator of Meditative Moments at Spiritual Essence Yoga and Wellness Center. Please welcome Mr. Eric Brewington. How are you today?
I'm good. Thank you so much for having me. Happy to be here.
Thank you so much for coming. Full disclosure, I used to attend your meditative classes and they were fantastic.
Excellent, excellent. I hope to see you back again soon.
Hope so too. So tell us a little bit about meditation.
Well, I'll start with what kind of led me to meditation. In addition to, I work full-time as a web developer, but I also play instruments. I play trumpet and I play bass guitar. And I will fully admit that my exploration of meditation had a lot to do with me trying to find an edge or trying to find that special something to improve my my music. Because many of my heroes, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, Sonny Rollins, several of them use meditation. So I was thinking, okay, maybe if I meditate, these things that are challenging for me will also become easier. But what I discovered was it was more than about music. It was about learning about myself. It was about relaxing myself. It became a very enriching process and something that I ultimately wanted to share with others. But the benefits of meditation are many and almost uncountable, but some of the benefits include reducing stress, which I believe you mentioned earlier. It can control anxiety. It can enhance your self-awareness. And through that self-awareness, you learn your triggers and the things that kind of get you upset. And you can kind of get ahead of them before they start to manifest themselves. It can generate kindness, which may seem a bit odd. But in the process of learning about ourselves, we become more patient with others. It can also lengthen your attention span or your focus. And it can do things like lower your high blood pressure and help with pain relief. So meditation is a wonderful thing.
Yes, it definitely does have a lot of physical as well as it sounds like emotional and psychological benefits. You mentioned that it was one way that you got to know yourself better. Can you tell us a little bit about that journey?
Yeah, absolutely. Through the process of meditation, and maybe just a teeny definition of meditation, some people think meditation is a process of emptying the mind so that the mind isn't thinking about anything. But some people, and myself included, believe that meditation is focusing on one thing. So that focus could be focusing on the breath. It could be focusing on a sound. It could be focusing on an image that you're trying to imagine in your mind. And in the process of doing that, you'll notice thoughts in your thinking. And a lot of times we don't pay attention to that. We knee-jerk react to the dialogue that's going on in our heads. I found a meditation slowed down that dialogue to where I could actually examine it. And through that examination, learn a lot more about myself and some of the things that I believed and some of the misconceptions that I had about myself and about things that may happen around me. So it played a pivotal role in me finding out more about myself and some of the things that make me tick. And I felt like I had a lot more control over the way I reacted to things. So that was extremely beneficial for me.
You know, I think you're right. When I think about when people talk about meditation, they say it's hard for them because they can't clear their mind and they can't sit for that amount of time. Is it that you're saying is when you say you focus on one thing, but you still will have other thoughts during that time? So that is normal, is that you'll have numerous thoughts while you're meditating.
Oh, absolutely. And that's a very important point. When a person first starts to meditate, they may become overwhelmed with the number of thoughts and things buzzing through their head. And they're like, oh my gosh, this isn't relaxing at all. This is actually making me more frustrated. But it's literally the first step in developing a meditation practice or learning about yourself, because you pay attention. You're now aware that, oh my gosh, my mind is extremely busy. Even when I don't think I'm thinking, there's all these thoughts whizzing about in our heads. And we, a lot of times we're not even aware of it. And meditation connects us to those thoughts. And we're a lot more aware of all the things that are going on in our minds.
That actually really is good to know, because I know that there are many people who say, because they are having so many thoughts, as you say, whizzing around, is that they give up. And then they say, this isn't for them. It actually leads to more stress, and it leads them to feel actually that they failed at meditation. What would help them keep going?
Well, I think it's the understanding that that busyness is almost like the first step. And I think you have to be very patient with yourself with anything new. I mean, and a lot of times people say, my mind is too busy, I can't meditate. Well, that's like saying, I'm out of shape, I can't go to the gym. You know, it's discovering that you do have that busy mind should be motivation to maybe explore that. And what happens is we have a busy mind. The mind is not really focused on anything. So the thoughts and the conversations are going on back and forth, back and forth. When we focus on one thing, like sometimes the breath, it gives the mind something to do. So instead of the brain just going all over the place, she's like, you know what, brain, I want you to focus on the breath. How does it feel to breathe? You know, when you inhale, what do you notice? When you exhale, what do you notice? I think the key for any beginner is to be patient. I think one of the keys is that you approach each session without any expectations. So if I sit down and meditate and I'm like, oh my gosh, this is gonna be so wonderful. It's gonna be calming. I'm gonna be relaxed. And when it doesn't meet that expectation, a lot of people become discouraged, and they're like, okay, that was nothing like what I imagined it to be.
Yes, I have definitely heard people say this.
I've said it myself. I think early on in my meditation practice, I did have that expectation where I had maybe one session that was so relaxing, and I was in the zone, so to speak, where I was able to turn off the noise. But then another day I sit down, and again, every day we're different. Every day we're dealing with different things. That time I sat down, my mind was everywhere. And I labeled that meditation session as a bad session, but there are no good sessions. There are no bad sessions. There simply is meditation, and it's going to be different every time you approach it. And I think whenever we approach it that way, without expectations, and we simply do it every day, that's when we see more consistent results. Consistency is the key.
So it's interesting. You said there are no bad sessions. So even if, let's say, a person is sitting down and they're meditating and they are having many thoughts and they're not achieving this relaxation that they desire, that still is considered, one, normal for their practice, and two, it's not indicative of something has happened or they couldn't meditate properly. We are expecting to see ebbs and flows in what our thoughts will be like.
No, absolutely. I mean, you know, we are, like I said, we're different every day. And there will be one day where my meditation practice will be, you know, bliss and butterflies and rainbows. And then I'll have another session where it's very busy. But I think even in the times that our minds are busy, it gives us an opportunity to say, okay, so why am I so, you know, why are my thoughts so scattered right now? It allows you the opportunity to do that deep dive, to dig in and maybe find out what's the root of, you know, the discomfort or for the busy mind. So every opportunity is an opportunity to get to know yourself better.
Well, this is great news coming from such a seasoned professional person who meditates and teaches meditation. So this is fantastic news to know that that process is normal. Even you experience that at times.
All the time.
So for us, I mean, when I say us, I mean psychologists, a session would be, let's say, 50 minutes long. What does a meditation session look like?
Well, it varies. I think for a beginner, you can start off with as small amount of time as 3 minutes. I think sometimes we get this idea that for meditation, we need to sit down for an hour, or we need to sit down for 10 minutes. You can literally get benefits from meditation if you're only sitting down for 3 to 5 minutes. But I think the key is consistency. It's not a thing where you do it once a week or you do it 2 or 3 times a week. I think you start to see the benefits from it when you are doing it every day. And I think if you set a manageable increment of time, like 3 minutes, you're more likely to stick to it.
So you feel like 3 minutes generally can produce those sort of benefits that you were referring to before: relaxation, reduction of your stress, actually lowering your blood pressure. In 3 minutes, we're able to accomplish that.
Absolutely. And again, the key is the consistency part. And what normally happens is when you start to see the benefits of meditation, you will welcomely, you know, expand that 3 minute time to a span of maybe 10 minutes or longer. You know, some people sit down for an hour and meditate. But I think when you first start out, it's a daunting task to kind of say, hey, I'm going to sit down for an hour and I'm not going to do anything but focus on my breath. I mean, if you've never done that before, it can be extremely challenging. And I think taking baby steps is the best way to start. So that's why I always say, if you're just starting out 3 minutes, you can still see the benefits of getting to know yourself better, giving your mind a break from running around in 100 different directions.
Mm-hmm. And so as you become more experienced, are you suggesting that naturally an individual will increase their time rather than planning it out saying, okay, today I'm going to actually sit down for an hour, that naturally it begins to happen that you'll be more inclined to meditate more with practice?
No, absolutely. I think, you know, you'll start out with 3 minutes and the 3 minutes will be a challenge to you. And then what you'll discover is as your mind gets used to that exercise for 3 minutes, that will be easy. So then you say, you know what, I'm just going to tack on another 2 minutes to make it 5 minutes. It's almost like lifting weights. You know, you start off with a weight that starts out very heavy, but then it becomes lighter. And then what do? You add more weight to it. So it's almost like adding additional time to your sessions is a way of it's a natural progression, but you don't automatically say, okay, you know what, after 1 week, I'm gonna go from 5 minutes to 20 minutes. You may not be ready for that. You know, you kind of have to take it as it comes. And there will even be days when, say, you've been meditating for 10 minutes consistently, and then it becomes a struggle. There's nothing wrong with rolling it back to 5 minutes and getting comfortable with that again, and then kind of slowly moving it forward. It's kind of like an ebb and flow, and your mind will kind of tell you what to do.
This is, it's so pleasant listening to this experience. And I say that because many people go into meditation with high expectations that they'll meditate for an hour, that they will experience this, again, bliss and the butterflies and rainbows that will come out of it, and that they'll be able to do that every single day without challenge. And that's actually the antithesis of what you're suggesting. You are saying that a person can go in, they need to begin practicing with little increments of time, and many times they won't necessarily feel more relaxed because they'll have a lot of thoughts going on, and there will be times even after practice that they'll have to roll back their time because that's not what they need.
No, absolutely. And I think getting that awareness out there will lead more people to kind of explore it, because like you said, there's a misconception of it's always bliss. And there are definitely days when, even myself, when I have meditation, I don't feel relaxed. I actually feel like it's a workout because I'm literally trying to go back and forth to focus. And when we talk about focusing on the breath, so you're focusing on your breath, I'm breathing, and then the thought will pop up, oh, but after this, I got to go to work. I got that meeting that I really don't want. You become aware of that lack of focus. You bring it back to the breath. So there's this constant ebb and flow. And what happens is the focus on the breath will become a little bit longer, and then it'll get distracted. You just have to bring it back. It's really about patience. It's really about consistency. And again, I think the important thing is to not have any preconceived idea of what each session is going to be like.
Well, why don't we start there? We're on to a great start. When we return, Mr. Brewington is actually going to lead us on a guided meditation. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
I never dreamed this career was possible. I absolutely love what I do. My name is Steven, and I'm a proud graduate of the University of the District of Columbia. I received my Master's of Public Administration in 18 months, and during that process, I had two promotions and graduated debt-free. The professors had real-life experiences. UDC helped me change my dreams from impossible to possible.
Find your possible. Visit udc.edu/possible to learn more.
Welcome back. We're here with Mr. Eric Brewington, who's going to actually walk us through a guided meditation with us today. Thank you again so much for coming in.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure. Very, very happy to be here and happy to share this with you. So to begin with meditation, one of the things we want to be mindful of is our physical comfort. So before you begin, making sure you are as physically comfortable as possible, because what will happen is if you're not comfortable, while you're trying to focus on your breath, your mind will say, oh, but my back hurts. Oh, but my legs are uncomfortable. So comfort of the physical body is very important before we even begin. So we'll all take a moment to kind of settle into our space, whether we're sitting down or lying down. And we can begin by taking a slow, relaxed, deep breath in. And then as you exhale, you can close or soften the eyes. And with the eyes closed or softened, you can tune into the space around you first by feeling the weight of your physical body pressing very gently down into the chair. You can feel the weight of the arms or the hands if they're resting in your lap or at your sides. And usually with the eyes closed or softened, we'll notice that our hearing suddenly becomes a lot more enhanced. So you can tune into any sounds that you hear around you, near or far. And the closest sound could be simply the sound of your own heartbeat, or maybe the sound of the air moving in and out of the nose. But throughout the meditation, not resisting any sounds that you hear, because our awareness of sound is simply being present, simply being in the moment. And then I invite you to allow your awareness to gently shift to your natural breath. And by natural breath, I mean the way that you breathe every day, every moment. And notice how your body responds to each breath. When you inhale, you may feel your belly expanding like a balloon. You may feel your rib cage opening and expanding as the air fills your lungs. And you may even feel your shoulders rising towards the sky ever so slightly. And as you exhale, now noticing the opposite, feeling your shoulders sinking down now at the beginning of the exhalation, feeling your rib cage closing in towards your heart as the air leaves your lungs, and feeling your belly deflating now like a balloon. But with each breath, with each gentle rising and falling, feel your physical body becoming more and more relaxed. And if you find yourself distracted by a sound or thought, simply acknowledge that you were distracted, but very gently and very patiently bring your awareness back to your breath. If you find it difficult to focus on your breath, simply say inhale as you're breathing in and exhale as you release the breath. And now just go ahead and bring awareness back to your physical body simply by wiggling fingers and toes very, very slowly. And once again, tuning into the space around you, first by allowing your awareness to drift to any sounds that you hear around you. And once again, feeling the weight of the physical body pressing down into the floor or the mat. And then taking a slow, relaxed, deep breath in. And as you exhale, very slowly opening your eyes and bringing full awareness back into your space. And hopefully feeling a bit more relaxed than you were when you first began the meditation.
That have really been 3 minutes? Go by so quickly.
It does, and that's something a lot of people, when they first meditate, especially with a guided meditation, is the passage of time. Time goes by very quickly when you're focusing on one thing, whether it be the breath or a sound or music or what have you. But it definitely gives the illusion of time passing by very quickly.
Right. You know, as I was mentioning how people say, oh, this is hard to sit for 3 minutes. And then when we did that, I thought, you said, and bring yourself back to awareness. I found myself pouting just a bit, like, no, not quite yet. could that happen to have been 3 minutes? How quickly that felt. You know, I have to wonder, as individuals are doing this as a beginner, would a guided meditation actually be better practice for them? Or do you recommend that they just try it solo, what you just helped us with today?
Well, no, I definitely think having guided meditation is beneficial to a beginner. And there are so many apps available on phones now, Headspace, Calm, I'm probably forgetting some, But there are so many apps that are available to help you and guide you through meditation. And it's a great place to start because it will give you the keys to focus on about preparing for meditation, focusing on your breath. And then once you get comfortable with it, you can lead your own meditation where you kind of don't need someone to guide you. You know that you're supposed to be comfortable. You know that you're supposed to kind of let the body settle and relax. You know that you're focusing on your breath. You know that you can say inhale when you're breathing in, exhale as you're releasing your breath. But I think if you just literally plop down in a chair, never meditated before, set a timer on your phone, you know, it can be very daunting without having a little bit of guidance to start out.
Mm-hmm. Well, I have to ask, did you actually become better at playing and music after meditating?
I did. And here's the interesting thing. It didn't happen the way that I expected it to. I think I mentioned the self-awareness thing. I learned more about myself. I became more patient with myself. So I recognized the negative chatter when I would practice or I would perform. And I was able to recognize that and maybe drown it out or maybe ignore it a lot better than I did before. Another thing, I don't know if I mentioned this, meditation does, is it definitely helps your focus. So it allowed me to focus during my practice session. So instead of me, you know, sitting down and then looking at my phone and then doing something else and looking out the window, it allowed me when I sat down to actually really focus on the task at hand, which was practice. So it helped me, but not in the ways that I expected it to. I thought that there would be like, you know, I'd sit down and it would be like this inspiration, this light from heaven would shine down on me and I would write all this amazing music. But it wasn't quite that dramatic. But it definitely, again, connected me to myself. And I think the key there is I think the more in tune we are with ourselves, the better we are able to do anything, whether that be music, whether that be our jobs, whether that's having a conversation with a family member. It just opens you up to a lot more success and patience and all the things we need to get through this wonderful thing called life.
Well, that is such a beautiful way to actually send us off and end today, is that whether it's with meditation or with other vehicles, that's what we're trying to do, better know ourselves and be able to be healthier. And I thank you so much for sharing this with us, Mr. Brewington. It's a very important aspect of having a healthy mind.
Absolutely. And again, thank you so much for having me. My pleasure. Thank you.
Thanks again for joining us on A Healthy Mind. We'll see you next time. If you'd like to get in contact with me, please follow me on Instagram @PsychMindedMedia. Have a good day. Bye-bye.